We're back. Hot Chix Cool Toy Review, and I am Wendy. Thank you, thank you. This time we're giving you guys a double dose of outer space sci-fi horror. Introducing the two latest MMS pieces from the Hot Toys Predator family, the 1/6 scale Berserker and Falconer. Yay! Now, we've already scoped out several rave reviews on these guys, but we actually feel that a bit of our honest two cents might differ. Okay, the packaging is nothing special. Besides the infrared plastic windows, these are nothing more than serve-the-purpose packages. A sleeve over a 5-panel window box. Yep, okay, get rid of it. Fancy as the AVP boxes, and nowhere near as cool as the classic Predator cloaking sleeve package. Some reviewers spend so much time on the packaging, even if it's blah. We'll focus on the figures unless it's something special. Both Berserker and Falconer look pretty cool out of the box, not as big as we expected, but everybody's heard that already. At the root of it all, the new body sculpts only sport 21 points of articulation. That's over 30% less than any older Predator figure at 32 points, which results in these guys having an extremely limited amount of posability. Forget about capturing any film-like or dynamic poses with these guys. Unless they're standing straight up, it's going to be tough. Berserker and Falconer share the same body sculpt but have slightly different skin color and pattern variations. Their armor is also pretty much identical, give or take a few accent pieces and undercloths. However, their armor has different paint schemes, but they appear uniform-like, and that's no problem since they belong to the same tribe. The Berserker's skin tone is a deep forest green, highlighted with pale green and light brown and red pattern accents. Armor is mostly a deep copperish color. The Falconer is a bright green with a light brown and sandy highlights. His armor is made up of bright copper tones and dark grayish combinations, but overall both these guys have excellent paint jobs. The Berserker's unique features include a removable biomask with a not so neat laser targeting feature. Our tri-laser looks more like a sloppy bi-laser. Somebody wanted to get off work early. A wrist computer, a plasma cannon, alternate sets of open and closed hands, alternate sets of open and closed mandibles, 3 separate length interchangeable metal gauntlet blades, and a human skull vertebrae trophy. We kind of felt a bit short-handed on the accessories. An environmental base or battle damage parts would have been nice. The Falconer's unique features include alternate open and closed hands, the left hand being gloved, 3 separate length interchangeable metal gauntlet blades, a classic Predator skull trophy, a static Falcon with almost nowhere to go, and an excruciatingly non-removable biomask with an even sloppier laser targeting feature, and no plasma cannon. What's the point? I see you, even though I can't shoot you! This guy is definitely headed for some major nip-tuck plastic surgery. The Berserker is at best okay in the features department, where the Falconer is ugh! An unarmed laser targeting system is a clear failure, and at this point in Hot Toys Predator line, any figure without a removable mask and switch-out mandibles is automatically in quality control violation. I don't want to hear any of this movie-accurate crap either. The Chopper, Celtic, Guardian, or the Lost Predator never showed their face on screen either. And finally, the Falcon was a last-minute addition, and it's pretty obvious. It is a static position utilizing a clear plastic pole with 1 mounting position, where the Falcon hovers above and behind the Predator's left shoulder. To top it off, we tried adjusting the mounting pole after it was set in place and it easily snapped. Oh well, it's pretty lame anyway, and it's got a date with a circular file right after this review. This is where Hot Toys could have grabbed the Predator by the mandibles and taken major strides. Give the Falcon some electronic features. Articulated wings, for goodness sakes. Can anyone say John Connor's Hydrobot? How about the Falcon actually having a landed mounting position on the Falconer's back, instead of hanging around like a pest? Where's the movie accuracy there? The lack of accessories could have clearly been nullified here. We were so incredibly bummed out over the whole no-face Falconer that we had to put him under the knife before we even reviewed him. This update makes a world of difference in our opinion, and this is how we would have released him, along with any future Predators as well. Introducing the Hot Chix Custom Falconer. Now, we've seen a couple of modified Berserker heads floating around on the internet, but this is an actual Falconer head with a one-of-a-kind, unique facial development. This guy is pimped out with 5 points of articulation in the lower jaw and mandibles, which Hot Toys has never done. Under the Hot Toys factory issued body mask, you only get half a face, left raw and unpainted and impossibly glued to the bio for even more difficulty with customization. This is pretty crummy for hobbyists with painting and sculpting skills, so after the treacherous ordeal of removing the bio mask, our in-house kit basher Jason developed and sculpted an individual likeness for the Falconer, and finally finished off the paint job. At least now, the Falconer no longer has to hide behind his bio mask. At this point, for $200 and upwards, Hot Toys should make it a point to over-accessorize all of their figures and let the owners personalize their model. They have obviously done this before with previous releases. Which brings us to another point. We actually prefer the old build-em-yourself style Hot Toys models with all the extras, like articulated wire hands, decorative stands, parts that function instead of switch out, removable armor that wasn't glued on, and loads of accessories. Fair is fair. We can't blame Hot Toys for the actual design of the Predator. After all, they were much simpler than the previous Predators. No body nets, spears, handheld weapons, bone trophy jewelry, etc. But we just think they lacked in the added features department, with the Falconer being the true offender. We think tons of things could have been done to compensate for the simplicity of the Predators' designs. These are the first Hot Toys figures that didn't absolutely wow us out of the box. Considering the evolution of Hot Toys Predator figure to date, we clearly think these guys are a step in the direction, especially when compared to the classic Predator or the Elder P2, who blew us away and were loaded with accessories with a smaller price tag. Okay, bottom line, we're not saying we regret buying these guys. We just felt let down a bit. They look great with the rest of the bunch, and they will most likely wind up being great investment pieces. We will, however, stand firm in saying that as far as our Hot Toys Predators go, we're going against the grain and saying out of the box, these guys are close to our least favorite. Sorry!